Welcome to our video on the seamless cloning technique, infusion cloning, from Takara Biosciences. This video covers 5 tips to improve your success using infusion cloning. Tip 1. Infusion cloning is a PCR-based technique, so success starts with successful PCR and thoughtful primer design. There are 2 important regions to consider in your PCR primers: the region that binds to your template, and the region that will overlap with your cloning vector or adjacent fragment. There is not always flexibility in selecting either of these regions, but if possible, you should avoid regions that can form stable secondary structures. Make sure that the length of the overlapping region is consistent with your cloning procedure. The overlapping tail should be 15 nucleotides long for single insert cloning reactions. In contrast, the overlaps for multi-insert protocols should extend to 20 nucleotides. Tip 2. Optimize your PCR reaction to minimize mutations and artifacts. Use a high-fidelity PCR polymerase for any PCR-based cloning technique, and keep rounds of PCR to a minimum, as each additional round of PCR will increase the number of mutations in your final product. In addition, optimize reaction conditions so that there are minimal subbands or PCR artifacts present in your PCR reaction. It is best to base your annealing temperature on the target-specific portion of your primer. Tip 3. After amplifying your vector and inserts, it is critical to clean up your PCR products before proceeding with the infusion reaction. PCR primers and PCR artifacts are compatible with the ends of your fragments and can act as inhibitors of the infusion reaction. If plasmid is the template for a PCR reaction, the residual intact plasmid can contribute to background colonies after transformation into E. coli. Finally, quantitation of purified DNA is more accurate, which is important for the infusion reaction. Tip 4. Pay attention to quantities. Molar ratios matter when setting up your infusion reactions. Manufacturer guidelines suggest a 2:1 insert-to-vector molar ratio for a single insert reaction. For multi-insert reactions, use twice as much of each insert relative to the vector. The total mass of DNA in your infusion reaction should not exceed 200 nanograms. Tip 5. Pay attention to the time. The infusion reaction is designed to proceed at 50 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes. The reagent exposes complementary overlapping regions but does not ligate them. Therefore, extra time will not help your infusion reaction and could hurt if exposed single-stranded areas are too long. To learn more about molecular cloning, visit snapgene.com.